Hi, my name is Jason Kang. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. From the previous videos, you know about what HTML and CSS are. I talked about how HTML is a structure, and CSS is the paintings and drawings on that structure that hook people up. Last but not least, this one is about JavaScript. JavaScript is used to create a dynamic and interactive experience for a user. Let's think about a newspaper. If you don't have JavaScript, all the web pages that you see on the internet would be like newspapers. If you watch Harry Potter, you probably remember Daily Prophet, which is the newspaper in the wizard world. Think about how pictures move and fonts and colors change in that newspaper. This is what JavaScript does. It brings all the cool effects that you see on the web page to the user. Then where did this JavaScript come from? If you want to understand how JavaScript came to this world, you have to go through some history of web browsers. In 1993, Mark Anderson, who was a lead developer at the National Center for Computing Applications at the University of Illinois, released the very first web browser called Mosaic. And then in 1995, Anderson founded Netscape, which launched the more advanced browser called Netscape Navigator. But Anderson wanted web to be more dynamic and interactive. He wanted users to interact with a web page as if it is alive, not to see some text and images. So Anderson thought we need a scripting language for the web. So Anderson brought in Brendan Eich, who has just joined Netscape to work on a project to build a programming language called Scheme. But then before he got to work on that, he joined the scripting language project. And it only took him 10 days to develop a programming language called Mocha, which was the very first version of JavaScript. When Mocha was released as a beta version, Netscape decided to change its name to LiveScript. But then there was this new programming language called Java, which was getting a lot of attention from engineers around the world. And it seemed very promising. So Netscape decided to officially change the name of LiveScript to JavaScript just to ride on the popularity of this new and up-and-coming language, Java. And yes, Java and JavaScript are not related at all. Netscape only took the name Java to make their new programming language popular to developers at the time. And it clearly worked really well. JavaScript is now one of the most popular programming languages in the world, and it's especially important if you are a front-end developer. That's it for now. In the next video, I'll show you how HTML, CSS, and JavaScript work together as a whole package. If you want to learn something specific, please leave them in the comments below so I can answer some of your questions. Thank you and stay tuned.